Here's something extraordinary about Kenya and the Olympic Games. Athletes from just the Rift Valley have won more medals in the last 50 years than any other country in the middle and long distances. And that's almost impossible to get your head around. So let's find out just how they do it. First on the list, altitude. We're heading to 8,000 feet. And those sorts of heights help peak running performance. But mountains are everywhere. So what makes Iten the home of champions? Well, first, the runners. Iten is home to about 1,000 athletes. Hundreds meet 6 days a week on this rural road.
It's okay.
Just run until you throw up, he says. No coaches are necessary. They thrive on teamwork and competition. But with so many, is running in the blood here? At this high school, it seems to be.
A couple of decades ago, St. Patrick's asked its former students who had become champions to donate trees. The problem is that they've had so many world-class athletes here that they run out of space.
Now, this particular photograph here, this was the Kenyan team taken with the president at State House, Nairobi.
Brother Colm O'Connell has coached champions at St. Patrick's for decades.
From one school, we had 10 representatives in the Seoul Olympics.
He says genetic theories of dominance are rubbish.
Nobody has yet come up with any conclusive evidence to say that there is a what you might call, a natural advantage here. So I think a lot has got to do with early identification of talent, the lifestyle of the people when they are young.
So they put the photos in the dining hall to motivate future champions, which brings us to another point.
The Kenyan diet in this part of the Rift Valley is very rich in carbohydrates and very low in fat. And really, they feel that the secret weapon is this, it's ugali. It's just very simple, maize and water. And it's a staple here. Runners love it, often even in the evening. And running legend has it that it's so popular and so effective that one coach in Europe shipped this all the way to his runners to improve their times.
More often than not, the runners now come in the other direction. Lorna Kiplagat, a world-class athlete who now runs for the Netherlands, says conditions are perfect here.
You can't find any other place in the world like this. It's the terrain, it's everything. I mean, you need to be here to feel it by yourself. But the atmosphere, it motivates you. The power has to come from your feet.
Elite athletes, including the entire English middle distance team, come to Kiplagat's High Performance Center. Many improve their times, but they come here for just a couple of weeks. And Brother Colm says you need a lifetime.
Very hungry and very motivated. And now, because we have a tradition in the area, the kids see the great champions training around here. And of course, they're highly motivated because these champions become great role models for our young kids growing up.
He says that the mind is as important as physical talent. So he picked out Moses Mokono for his will to succeed.
I came to realize even if a person doesn't have a knowledge, but you can run well and you can be a success in your life. Even if you didn't go to school, but you can run. And you can earn your life through your athletic.
For Mokono, like many other Kenyan athletes, running can mean a ticket to an education, recognition, and the potential for a better life. So what then ultimately makes Kenyans the best? Perhaps it's just the magic of these mountains. David McKenzie, CNN, Iten.